is no imam at all. Because the moment you reject the appointment of Allah, then you cease to exercise the right to lead others.
Huzur, I agree entirely with your point, Huzur. But you just said earlier in an earlier statement that we should not do the judgment ourselves. I have been to that mosque, I have said my prayers behind that imam.
But why do you misunderstand
me? May I please finish my statement?
No, first rectify that statement you are attributing to me.
Yes.
When I said, I did not say that you not make judgment. I never said it. I said, don't behave like Allah.
Yes.
Try to behave like human being and judge as human being, not as God.
Yes.
That's all.
Yes. Okay, I'll accept that.
Okay, now you continue with your.
If I just saw a mosque any place.
Innocently, not knowing that he's an Ahmadi or not.
Yes.
Yes.
And I walk in the mosque and I say my prayer.
No, nothing wrong there.
Nothing wrong. No. If the imam doesn't say anything against Ahmadiyyat.
No, that is different thing. When he, this is just an excuse which will not satisfy your conscience. I am quite certain. It is just an excuse, nothing more. The fact is that you know that that man does not believe in Masih Maud alayhi salam. If put to him, even if he is not denying in vehemently and calls him bad names, still he does not believe in his imamat.
There is a big assumption there.
Where is the assumption?
The assumption is that you are implying that this particular person is denying Hazrat Mirza.
No. Why? I'm not implying at all. The one who has not accepted Ahmadiyya,
yes,
and the message of Ahmadiyyat has spread everywhere and everybody knows of it, that it is an automatic conclusion. There is no assumption. Why don't you ask such an imam? Before, when you know it is not an Ahmadiyya mosque,
yes,
when you know the attitude of all the sects of Islam other than Ahmadis towards Ahmadiyyat, don't you know that?
Yes.
And you are giving them this right of not knowing what you are. You know their attitude,
yes,
and they don't know you. This is very strange. I mean, how are you duping yourself? This is why I said, what is essential is to be true to yourself. Be true to yourself. Don't construct excuses. If you are honest and true to yourself, you cannot conceive of any Muslim imam being an imam of a mosque and yet not rejecting Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam unless he has not heard the message. In that case, you know it is not an Ahmadiyya mosque, you should deliver the message to him and find out the reaction. This would be exactly a situation like somebody who has not heard of Islam and who is a pagan. He is innocent. Can you make him your leader in religious affairs? Must you? Why not? He has not heard of Rasulullah's name, he has not heard of Islam, he is quite innocent. Why don't you choose him as your leader?
But I'll be very honest with you. I just feel I have a guilty conscience because I live only hardly 10 steps from the mosque there. And while people are coming from far to say their prayers there, me as a Muslim, I shouldn't go there 10 steps to say my prayers.
That is not 10 steps to light, it is 10 steps to darkness. If you truly believe in Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, that is the most important question. What is his position in your view? Is he not an appointed leader by Allah who was predicted by Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasalam? Or is he? That is the point. What do you think?
Well, Huzur.
No, Huzur. Allah first. Keeping Allah in view,
yes,
answer me this question. Do you believe in him,
yes,
as the true Imam Mahdi, which was being expected for the last 14 centuries, which was sent by Allah as predicted by Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is he not that or not, or is he?
Well, he would be wrong, yes.
Huh?
He would be wrong.
No, just a minute. If that is decided?
Yes, that's decided.
Now go to that imam who lives just 10 steps ahead from you,
yes,
and ask him, if Imam Mahdi comes and some body does not accept him as the imam, can anybody say prayer behind him? What is his position? Ask him, and then let me know the answer. He would be closer to the truth than you are at the moment. Because ask any Muslim imam this question, that if you truly believe that Imam Mahdi has come and you have got initiated at his hands as the Imam Mahdi, can you say your prayer behind anyone who has not accepted him? They would say anyone who has not accepted him is not a Muslim. That would be their declaration. So you are not accepting that declaration in their favor. You first experiment on this. Where has Allah told you that you must say your prayers behind those who have rejected one of my messengers? Has the Holy Quran said it anywhere in any verse?
No.
If you live one step from a church which also calls to Allah for worship, why don't you enter that? Why doesn't your conscience bite you?
Well, Huzur, to answer that question, I have been to church and say my prayers as well, and to synagogue.
And to synagogue. This is your religion?
No, I have been to all these places before I believe.
No, now, when you have become a Muslim conscientiously and honestly, would you still say your prayer in the church if it is just one step from your place of residence?
No, I don't think so.
No?
No.
Why not? Where would be your conscience go? A prayer for Paul is made daily or in the morning in the church, and you don't listen to it. Because Islam permits you to say your own prayer if you have not an imam from among yourself. This is why Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted that Imam Mahdi would come and Masih would come, imamukum minkum. Then your imam would be from among you, not from outside you. This was a prediction made. Wa imamukum minkum. That was the wa added, which is an atf, which means when the Imam Mahdi comes, that is one thing. And another explanation is that from then on, your imam will be from among yourselves. Now, that is one thing. Also, you are totally ignorant of what they believe, behind whom you want to say your prayer to establish your Muslim nature. That is what is in fact the motive force, that nobody should pick you out as something different. While they themselves declare, ask first the sect of that imam. What is your sect? And then I can produce for you the evidence of the leaders of that sect, that no non-believer in that sect can lead their prayer. Not only that, they go one step further. No non-believer in that sect can come to their mosque and make it filthy with his presence. No non-believer of that sect can say prayer behind them. No non-believer of that sect can be married into them. So why are you violating their rules? If you are at liberty to violate your own rules, at least have regards for their rules. This is their set course of conduct. They don't want Ahmadis to say their prayer behind them. They don't want Ahmadis to enter their mosque, not only to mention the Ahmadis. They don't want any other follower of the sect, according to their official declarations, not according to the idiosyncrasies of some one person. According to their official declaration, this is exactly their view. This is why people who entered Sunni mosques while they happened to be Shias have been slaughtered in the history of Islam. People who believed in raising one finger while saying Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, this index finger, have been, after they went to a mosque where they did not raise the fingers, people of that sect noticed the absence of the rising finger and they cut the finger off, and the vice versa happened. So when this is their own belief, why do you violate their conduct plus your own? Do you want to create disorder everywhere? both in the Ahmadiyyat as well.